वेलकम माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विथ यू सेवरल एंटी नेचुरल एंड अनसाइंटिफिक हाइपोथेसिस व्हिच आर ऑब्जेक्टिवली प्रेजेंट विद इन द फ्रेमवर्क एंड करिकुलम ऑफ नेचुरल साइंस। इन दिस कनेक्शन आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड 7 वीडियोज। दिस इज माय फर्स्ट वीडियो out of 7 videos on anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. You will find each lecture either contrary or contradictory to your acquired and possessed basic scientific knowledge. My dear friends, I do not have any authority over your sense of right and wrong. You may just try to reflect on the contents of each lecture in correspondence to reality, that is, observation of particular instances. Observation of particular instances is the first stage of scientific hypothesis. If a framed hypothesis goes either contrary or contradictory to observation of particular instances, then that framed hypothesis is called an anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. Observation of particular instances is the material ground of both scientific certainty and inductive generalization. Newton observed an apple falling to the ground. That observation was the material ground of Newton's scientific generalization or Newton's law of gravitation. Observation of particular instances is the necessary and sufficient condition for verification of scientific hypothesis in correspondence to reality. I have prepared 57 slides on anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. This slide is giving you information regarding 57 slides of my 7 lectures on anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis, as well as references of formal grounds and legitimate grounds of my 7 lectures on anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. In this slide, you will find a few verifiable and justifiable quotes related to my 7 lectures on anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. You just try to grasp the significance of each quote within the framework and curriculum of natural science and necessary humanistic vision of education. I discussed about natural constitution, infallible and ironic mandates, and several concepts in my previous classes. So today, I shall not discuss with you contents of our previous classes. More specifically, today I shall not discuss with you slide number 4 to slide number 9. Today I shall try to share with you contents of slide number 10 to slide number 14. Let us start with Socratic conversational method. Try to understand the contents of this conversation. Student, what is a rose? Answer of the teacher. Teacher, a rose is a flower. Student, what is a flower? Teacher, a flower is a substance. Student, what is a substance? Teacher, a substance is a substratum. A substance is a substratum. Student, what is a substratum? Teacher, a substratum is the container of all the properties of a substance. A substratum is the container of all the properties of a substance. Student, what is the ultimate substratum? Teacher, universe is the ultimate substratum. Universe is the ultimate substratum. Now, try to understand the ultimate substratum. Universe is the ultimate substratum of all created beings and things. Projected solar system of global scientific community cannot be the ultimate substratum of all created beings and things, such as Sirius binary system, substratum of physics, substratum of astronomy and astrophysics, galaxy of approximately 1,24,000 stars like diamonds, 9 planets as 9 eye-opening evidences, Uranian system, natural magnetism, and Mercurial system. So, our universe is not a solar system or a solar universe. Our universe is not a solar system or a solar universe. Projected solar universe or solar system of global scientific community is an anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis within the framework and curriculum of natural science. Projected solar universe or solar system of global scientific community is an anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis within the framework and curriculum of natural science. Global scientists have been consciously and intentionally violating UN Universal Declaration of our inalienable human rights, projecting several anti-natural and unscientific hypotheses. A non-existent thing such as Spider-Man or solar universe cannot be made into existence by the finite rational beings of the entire world. So, global scientists and competent academic authorities of this equal and opposite manifested nature are absolutely unable to prove projected and communicated solar universe or solar system as the ultimate substratum of all created beings and things. On the contrary, we are able to prove that all man-made mechanisms, all well-established technologies, all digital sciences, all books and journals, and so far research works, etc., in resemblance with projected solar universe or solar system of an anti-natural community called global scientific community are nothing but anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis, anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis, and propagation of the nexus of self-contradictory and paradoxical knowledge, propagation of the nexus of self-contradictory and paradoxical knowledge. People of this equal and opposite manifested nature are the self-evident victims of projected anti-natural and unscientific hypotheses of inborn terrorists and communicated nexus of self-contradictory and paradoxical knowledge of black and white activists. Global scientists are anti-natural terrorists and antisocial activists. They have recognized the ultimate substratum of all created beings and things, verifiable framework of this manifested nature, and several uncontradicted facts of this equal and opposite manifested nature, such as Sirius binary system, Uranian system, natural magnetism, mercurial system, and barrier between equal and opposite natural mechanism, etc. However, they have been consciously and intentionally concealing from us their searched out natural sciences in a separate sheet. They have been consciously and intentionally concealing from us their searched out natural sciences in a separate sheet since antiquity. They have been uninterruptedly propagating several anti-natural and unscientific hypotheses within the framework and curriculum of natural science since antiquity. Consequently, we know nothing about the ultimate substratum of all created beings and things, verifiable framework of this manifested nature, and several uncontradicted facts of this equal and opposite manifested nature, such as Sirius binary system, Uranian system, natural magnetism, mercurial system, and barrier between equal and opposite natural mechanism, etc. After having known much about projected solar universe, solar system, well-established technologies, digital sciences, universal acceptance of the global scientific community, I have searched out nothing save the concealed sheet, save the concealed sheet of global scientific community. I have recognized the ultimate substratum of all created beings and things, verifiable framework of this manifested nature, and several uncontradicted facts of this equal and opposite manifested nature, such as Sirius binary system, four basic fields, four basic forces, four cardinal directions of helium 4 atom, Uranian system, natural magnetism, mercurial system, barrier between equal and opposite natural mechanism, and four points of light, etc., in resemblance with the concealed sheet of global scientific community and in correspondence to reality mentioned in page 27 of our National Curriculum Framework 2005, that is, one common, comprehensive, unerring, legitimate, clear and distinct textbook of Newton's laws and Einstein's sciences, after almost 30 years of search for truth, Now, I shall try to communicate with you the concealed sheet of global scientific community, that is, one common, comprehensive, unerring, legitimate, clear and distinct textbook of Newton's laws and Einstein's sciences, producing references of concealed scientific names and scientific character codes, of global scientific community, such as diamond operator or Unicode hex 25CA. Scientific code Unicode hex 25CA and the name diamond operator. Finite rational beings do not have any authority over natural mechanism or a priori science or pure science unmixed with man-made technologies or objective science or independent science or positive science. Finite rational beings have authority over man-made mechanism or a posteriori science or well-established anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. So, finite rational beings are absolutely unable to falsify and reject the searched out natural mechanism or a priori science or pure science unmixed with man-made technology. You just try to understand verifiable certain knowledge and justifiable valid knowledge, that is, unerring knowledge or vidya or pure science unmixed with man-made technology or positive science. Global scientists have recognized the ultimate substratum of all created beings and things as a mighty star. They have named that mighty star as diamond operator. Sirius or helium 4 atom or end of proof Unicode hex 220E, scientific code Unicode hex 220E, and the name of our manifested universe, end of proof. Global scientists have named our manifested universe as end of proof. Now, let us try to understand Sirius binary system or binary star system or two horizons, west horizon and east horizon of the upright rectangular universe. Universe was revealed as a trinity. Revealed trinity is called Sirius binary system. Binary star system. Upper half of the Sirius binary system. Is called White Dwarf Companion Sirius B. Upward 3D arrow of scientific certainty represents towards White Dwarf Companion Sirius B or strong field or west horizon or white square. Lower half of the Sirius binary system is called Sirius A. Downward 3D arrow of scientific certainty represents towards Sirius A. Towards Sirius A. Or gravitational field, or east horizon, or black square. White square and black square. White square, white dwarf companion Sirius B, and black square, Sirius A. Sirius A is the substratum of physics or gravitational field. White dwarf companion Sirius B is the substratum of astronomy and astrophysics. Strong field. Universe is the ultimate substratum of white dwarf companion Sirius B and Sirius A, that is Sirius binary system. Universe is the ultimate substratum of Sirius binary system. White dwarf companion Sirius B is called white square, and Sirius A is called black square. Sirius A or black square, guarded by the four basic forces. Sirius A or black square, guarded by the four basic forces, is called planet Saturn. Sirius A, guarded by the four basic forces, gravitational force, strong force, magnetic force, weak force. Sirius A, guarded by the four basic forces, is called planet Saturn. Finite rational beings cannot go beyond planet Saturn, that is Sirius A, guarded by the four basic forces. White dwarf companion Sirius B, adorned with stars like diamonds, is called planet Jupiter. White dwarf companion Sirius B, adorned with stars, approximately 124,000 stars like diamonds, is called planet Jupiter. Now, it is crystal clear that projected, running and moving planet Saturn and running and moving planet Jupiter, global running and moving planet Saturn and global running and moving planet Jupiter are anti-natural and unscientific hypotheses within the framework and curriculum of natural science. Black square has a peg. Black square or east horizon or Sirius A or gravitational field has a peg. So black square is immovable. World has been manifested within the black square. It is an invisible filler between white dwarf companion Sirius B and Sirius A. That invisible filler is called prime meridian. Universe is a mighty star or a diamond operator. Universe was revealed as a trinity. That revelation was an equal and opposite revelation. So, our universe has two horizons and two hemispheres. Two horizons are west horizon and east horizon. Two hemispheres are northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Our universe has been manifested as an upright rectangle. that manifested upright rectangular universe is called end of proof. Manifested upright rectangular universe is called end of proof. This is the prime meridian. Left side of the prime meridian. Left side of the prime meridian is called northern hemisphere or magnetic field or aphelion. E point, entering point of the so-called sun for the eastern daylight time zone and ending point of the so-called sun for the western daylight time zone. E point means entering and ending of the equal and opposite stages of journey of the so-called sun. That E point represents magnetic field, aphelion, northern hemisphere, left of the prime meridian. Right side of the prime meridian is called southern hemisphere or weak field or perihelion. T point, setting of the so-called sun for the eastern daylight time zone of North America and South America, and rising point of the so-called sun for the western daylight time zone of Africa, Asia, Australia, Arabian Peninsula and Europe is called T point. T point represents weak field, perihelion, southern hemisphere, right side of the prime meridian. Here is the northern hemisphere of the upright rectangular universe, southern hemisphere of the upright rectangular universe. Northern hemisphere of the upright rectangular universe and southern hemisphere of the upright rectangular universe. There are canopies. There are elliptical barriers. There are elliptical barriers between white dwarf companion Sirius B and Sirius A. These elliptical barriers between white dwarf companion Sirius B and Sirius A are called canopies. Canopies. There are 7 canopies. World has been manifested as a hexagon within the east horizon. Here is the world, here is the manifested world, and there are elliptical barriers or canopies above the world. We cannot go beyond these elliptical barriers or canopies. Finite rational beings cannot go beyond these elliptical barriers or canopies. Now, the manifested hexagonal world within the east horizon of the upright rectangular universe appears as if a global world due to these elliptical canopies above the world. Once again, world has been manifested within the east horizon as a hexagon. Manifested hexagonal world is appearing as a pentagonal earth with 3 ascending stairs within the east horizon of the upright rectangular universe. Now, there are elliptical barriers between white dwarf companion Sirius B or domain of astronomy and astrophysics and the substratum of physics. These elliptical barriers are called canopies. Now, due to these canopies, manifested hexagonal world appears as if a global world. So we misunderstood the manifested hexagonal world as a running and moving global world due to these elliptical canopies. Our atomic universe has four basic fields, four basic forces, and four cardinal directions. Our atomic universe has four basic fields, four basic forces, and four cardinal directions. Four basic fields are gravitational field, strong field, magnetic field, and weak field. Four basic fields are gravitational field, strong field, magnetic field, and weak field. Four basic forces are magnetic force, gravitational force, strong force, and weak force. Four basic forces are gravitational force, strong force, magnetic force, and weak force. Four cardinal directions: gravitational field or east horizon, so east direction; strong field or west horizon, that means west direction; northern hemisphere or magnetic field, natural north direction; southern hemisphere or weak field, natural south direction. Crucified sign is the crucial instance or clear proof of four basic fields, four basic forces, and four cardinal directions. West horizon, east horizon, two horizons, west horizon and east horizon. Two hemispheres, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Now you will find 4H, east horizon H, west horizon H, northern hemisphere H, southern hemisphere H. So our manifested universe is called helium 4 atom. Helium 4 atom has four basic fields: gravitational field, strong field, magnetic field, and weak field. Four basic forces: gravitational force, strong force, magnetic force, and weak force. Four cardinal directions: natural east, natural west, natural north, natural south. Gravitational force and strong force. Gravitational force and strong force are equal and opposite forces. Gravitational force and strong force are equal and opposite forces. Magnetic force and weak force are equal and opposite forces. Magnetic force and weak force are equal and opposite forces. Now, if upward direction, upward 3D arrow of scientific certainty, upward direction represents towards northern hemisphere, if upward direction represents towards projected northern hemisphere, then the downward direction will represent towards southern hemisphere. That means if upward direction represents towards northern hemisphere, then upward direction is called magnetic field, and downward direction is called weak field or southern hemisphere. We know that the downward 3D arrow of scientific certainty, that means downward direction, represents towards gravitational field, that means gravitational force. So it is self-evident that the upward 3D arrow of scientific certainty or upward direction represents towards strong field, because strong force and gravitational force are equal and opposite forces. So if downward direction is called gravitational field, then upward direction is strong field. If downward direction is called towards gravitational field, then upward direction will represent towards strong field. Gravitational field is called east horizon and strong field is called west horizon. So downward 3D arrow of scientific certainty represents towards natural east direction, and the upward 3D arrow of scientific certainty represents towards natural west direction. However, it is being taught that the upward 3D arrow of scientific certainty represents towards northern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere has been projected in the solar system of global scientists towards upward direction. So upward 3D arrow of scientific certainty represents towards northern hemisphere or magnetic field of the solar system, and downward 3D arrow of scientific certainty represents towards gravitational field or east horizon of the global scientific community in their projected and communicated anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. Gravitational force and magnetic force. Gravitational force and magnetic force are not equal and opposite forces. Gravitational force and weak force are not equal and opposite forces. So it is self-evident that anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis and self-contradictory and paradoxical sciences are being taught at school regarding four basic forces, four basic fields, and four cardinal directions, consciously and intentionally violating our inborn human rights, UN Universal Declaration of our inalienable human rights, and so far established right to education and human rights. It is crystal clear from all perspectives or disciplines that projected and communicated northern hemisphere or magnetic field towards upward 3D arrow of scientific certainty and projected and communicated southern hemisphere or weak field towards downward 3D arrow of scientific certainty are nothing but anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis of original terrorists and black and white activists of an international organization of terrorism and activism. That international organization of terrorism and activism is called UNO. UNO is neither a nation nor a constitution. UNO is neither a nation nor a constitution. UNO is an anti-natural, anti-human, anti-social, anti-cultural, anti-religious, illicit, illegitimate, unlawful, and unconstitutional organization of inborn terrorists called global scientists and real activists or black and white activists. So-called educated persons of the entire world are absolutely unable to prove that the downward 3D arrow of scientific certainty represents towards southern hemisphere and gravitational field. They are also absolutely unable to prove that the upward 3D arrow of scientific certainty represents towards northern hemisphere and magnetic field. So, it is crystal clear that several anti-natural and unscientific hypotheses are being taught at school, consciously and intentionally violating all established right to education and human rights. Now, my dear friends, try to recognize and confirm two horizons and two hemispheres of the upright rectangular universe, or four basic fields, four basic forces, four cardinal directions of our atomic universe, or helium 4 atom. Your success will prove that you are the possessors of common sense. You are the possessors of common sense. You will be able to identify several anti-natural and unscientific hypotheses objectively present within the framework and curriculum of natural science. Moreover, you will be able to search out necessary remedial measures for the identified anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis. You will practically realize the existential import of your conscious instrument or upright logic. I am concluding my first lecture on anti-natural and unscientific hypothesis, wishing you all the best and thanking you all.